Hi everyone, welcome to Brick. Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Mike and we do all kinds of LEGO stuff here, LEGO reviews, whatnot. Today we have the new Spider-Man Far From Home set, that is the 76128 Molten Man Battle. Sounds delicious or crazy. Like a molten chocolate, like a molten, like a fondue. Anyway, again, set number 76128, we have 294 pieces, 3 minifigures included, and what seems to be a really cool looking creature or a mech that's made out of molten lava and other city elements that just happen to be lying around. Now, this is part of the wave of the Spider-Man Far From Home set wave. 3 sets in total were produced for this movie. The movie should be coming out quite soon, and I feel terrified for one of my first videos on this channel, so please forgive me if I do any mistakes, like knocking over a minifigure or something, because it already happened. Anyhow, let's start with the minifigures. I think we have a pretty solid selection here. However, I'm not a very big fan of that firefighter. The Spider-Man, though, this guy looks awesome. I'm not entirely sure which version of Spider-Man that is. That seems to be like some sort of a super high-tech carbon fiber suit, maybe the one that Iron Man gave to Peter Parker, who knows, but this is a super exclusive minifigure at this point. One of the very few black-looking Spider-Mans, excellent print for the torso. I really enjoy that kind of a stealth suit on him. Reminds me of, remember that old game Splinter Cell with Sam Fisher? That was a pretty decent game, and this guy looked kind of like the Spider-Man. Also maybe reminds me a bit of the Spider-Noir from the Spider-Verse movie. Maybe, who knows, but holy moly, we have a lot of detailing here. We have a really cool armor, there is a belt with utilities, a super decent print for the legs, their toes are printed as well, showcasing his stealth boots, whatnot. The back also shows some technical equipment, and the head itself has a pattern of stripes with a lot of detailing on the front and on the back. You can see the spider eyes with some sort of a vision and enhancement equipment of sorts, I'm not really sure, but there is also a strap in the back, maybe that is a version of a goggles, like night vision goggles, who knows. Favorite minifigure in this set, really cool looking guy. Spider-Man collection would be super nice with this guy around. This guy has the actual spider web in a shooting motion. There is a connection point that you can actually snap him to one of the molten man's hands that way, so in that sort of way he kind of looks like he's trying to battle him in a very dynamic fashion. Really cool thing right there. We get a bunch of other elements here. You guys see some of the spider webs, the cuffs that, you know, you can use them as handcuffs for the minifigures, and an extra spider web blast that comes with the set. Very, very cool. Mysterio. I think this guy appears in one other set, so he's not exclusive. Let me just check. I was correct, he does appear in the Hydro Man Attack set as well, so two instances of this guy appearing in the current wave of sets. And we don't know much about Mysterio because his name is Mysterio, but yeah. Anyway, he doesn't have a face, just a silver, actually, minifigure head, which is quite unusual, I gotta say. He comes with a spongy, very soft cloth, purple cape, which is awesome, and a piece that I do not see quite often, the minifigure headgear, just a ball, like a fishbowl, in clear transparent coat. Mysterio has a solid print on the front and on the back. I kind of reminds me of a Superman suit for some reason, but it does have a contrast of purple, gold, and dark green. Very detailed print, so actually a decent minifigure, just not exclusive to this set. He also comes with a pair of the Power Blast elements that appear in many superhero sets as a play feature, so you can boom, like, alright, fight Spider-Man with that. So we have to see until the movie who actually Mysterio is, or maybe he's a character from the comic books that I'm not aware of because I am not as nerdy as you think. And the third minifigure is the firefighter from City, basically. I mean, I think he's kind of exclusive, I would have to check the print with other City minifigures, but he could easily appear in a City set with any firefighters included. That's the case usually, quite often actually, with the superhero sets, the guys from the civilian side of things, like police officers and firefighters, do appear in the superhero sets. So this is kind of a good example of this. I do like, however, the fact that he does come with a fire extinguisher built from the old school flintlock pistol piece, and also some technical elements to make for that fire extinguishing liquid tank. He does have one single face expression and a firefighter's hat, and that concludes the minifigures. That was a long segment. And now on to the molten man. Man, this guy looks awesome. You gotta appreciate the thought process and the creativity behind this guy. First of all, the first thing you notice is that it's some sort of a creature made from, well, molten lava, obviously, or some sort of a other magma thing going on here, with a combination of street elements. So things you notice on this guy is the lamppost on his left hand. There is the street sign on one of his shoulders. We get also a traffic light molded into his arm on the right side. So that really gives you this creature out of nowhere created in the city battle kind of look. I love the hood of the car in the front melted into his chest. That's really awesome. And overall, these elements kind of contrast in color and shape overall against anything else on this guy. The rest of the body is built using dark bluish gray bricks. Also, you get the molten elements, which are plentiful in this set. The drippings of molten material are really cool, very well made, with the antenna pieces just connected in a very subtle way to the body, just dripping onto the surface. That adds this much more of a kick to the look of this guy. We get a combination of printed and molded and dual molded elements, plus this guy just keeps falling over, and stickers as well. The prints include obviously the face. I think it's a shoulder piece from the Big Figs series. I think I've seen that shoulder used in a Boba Fett, I think, for example. But this guy has a printed face, which is quite scary looking. I would just try to fight this guy as a boss if it was in a Diablo game. We also get a bunch of stickers showcasing the cracks in his lava body, together with some rock elements printed on, and the whole thing actually works pretty darn well with those slope elements. Let me just take one off to show you. Okay, I'm gonna show it closer to the camera. I can see the clear zoom in right now, perhaps, that these guys are dual molded in a way that there is the transparent orange element topped off with the golden rock elements, portraying that lava crispy gold look. It looks really awesome. Same goes for the feet of the guy. So these elements are used like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 times on the body at least. Plus there's also some elements without the golden encrust, the golden imprint on them. So there's a good contrast, and overall the looks are solid. The guy is super posable, so you can actually, you get those usual ball joints on the arms and all the limbs. Actually, you can just pose the way you want with his legs. There are no ratcheted joints, so there is no limit, there is no limitation of the movement you can achieve. And he also gets the stud shooter, the six shooter, which is very well made using the big space wheel, as I call them. That's the element from the rovers, for example, from the space line of Lego, and that allows you to get an extra grip on that arm and shoot the elements with little to no difficulty. And I think that's gonna be it for this overview of this set, this sort of a review. Do I like it? Yes, I do. We have $30 set with 294 pieces. That is not bad nor good. I think it's a very average price for a set of this size. It's recommended if you are into Spider-Man. You get a very excellent version of Spider-Man in black. Plus Mysterio comes in this set. The other set is a bit more expensive, so it's a cheaper way to get him. The Firefighter is a throw-in just to be connected with the theme, like this guy is trying to really fight the Molten Man with that fire extinguisher. Good luck with that. Alright, and that's gonna be it for this review. Thank you guys so much for watching, and one more thing before you go. I would really appreciate you guys to check out my eBay page. It's in the links below. I am selling the sets that I review on this channel. I'm not trying to make any profit out of it. I'm just trying to get back a bit of the cost in order to keep doing the videos for you and support myself in my independent endeavor on YouTube. So if you guys are okay with getting a used set built by me with complete minifigures and the box just built for much lower price than you would otherwise get in any official retailer, then I would really appreciate it. That helps me pretty much keep the costs down for this channel and allowing me to have more time and put more effort into making regular videos for you. So thank you so much for considering that. As always, you can leave a like right below and subscribe. Tell your friends that Mike is back with LEGO videos, and you can click the bell button for notifications. I always appreciate it. That allows me to do what I love to do. You guys are awesome. I hope to have your support in my future endeavors and be able to bring you regular videos with more awesome sets to review. Thank you so much for watching. It was Mike, and I'll see you next time on this channel. Bye bye. First review, huh? You're gonna be famous one day.
You're dead!
Wow. Sounds good! Very nice! To be or not to be? Flame on! I have no idea what I'm doing.